Top contender Ulrika Meyer, back in 89, she won the Super G gold medal at the World Championship. Pregnant with this young lady, Melanie, now 2 and a half, there with her father, Hubert Schweighofer, who's a policeman. He and Melanie here to cheer on Ulrika Meyer. Just 24 years of age, she is a real tough competitor.
She nearly stole a bronze in the combined after not running slalom at all this season. Skied fantastically. She just loves the big event. She always comes on, does her best skiing when the pressure's on. Meyer, a very aggressive giant slalom skier. Again, the rolled shoulders. Now, while you would think that that would put pressure on the tips of the skis, watch how she works off the tail, especially down here on the flat. She gets her hips low. Very nice skiing. We'll see how she handles this difficult section here that have given so many racers trouble. Ooh, no problem at all. And 0.3 seconds ahead at that split. She's doing it again, Tim.
Yes, she is. Meyer can never be taken for granted in a big event.
Let's see how she does down here on the bottom, where the turns get very quick. The Americans overturn down here on this section of the course.
Vieberg's time to be to the left of the screen. First run of two, Meyer into the lead. Ulrika Meyer of Austria takes the lead away from Pernille Vieberg. And little Melanie loves that. Pernille Vieberg does not. Now preparing for her start, yesterday's Super G champion, Deborah Compagnoni, already being called Tombagnoni in her native Italy after superstar Alberto, whom she has trained with and emulates. Well, here she is, 21 years old, Deborah Compagnoni, winner of the Super G yesterday, 4 second-place finishes in World Cup giant slalom races this year. She's coming in here with a hot hand.
She has never won a giant slalom race, but boy, is she ready. She skied so well in the Super G, so much stronger than anybody else.
Compagnoni is down here on the top of the hill. Deborah Compagnoni is out of it. She's hurt. Looks like her knee, Coop.
Oh, Tim, and she is a tough competitor. She would not be crying that way if she were not very badly hurt.
What a tough break for this great young champion.
And take a look at this line as she comes in here. Very direct, as we saw earlier. Perfect position here. She just leans in slightly. There's so little room for error. And that's where she gets hurt, I believe, as she falls back over to the left.
Twisting her knee, trying to stand up again, it appears. So Compagnoni joins Schneider and Kronberger out of it here in the first run. And here's how they stand. After the first run, Ulrika Meyer of Austria in first place, and Rolf Steinrodder 1:05 back.
Never has Diane needed a flawless run more desperately than she needs one now, and she has been frustrated at her inability to come up with one. And on that first run, a full second back, nearly taking herself out of contention for a medal. That is a lot of time to make up in a field as tough as this one.
Rolf Steinrodder must regret at this point that she didn't go harder on the first run, but she is really tough on the top.
She's battled the favorites all year, and now she trails a whole nother set of racers by more than she usually gives the favorites in a World Cup race.
That's her combined time.
And nice turns right there. Very clean, very aggressive. This is a much turnier course than the first run. That should suit Diane's style better. And so far in the upper half of this course, she has skied much cleaner, much more aggressively than on the first run.
Rolf Steinrodder to the bottom now. A lot of turns here to the finish line. Into first place. But the leaders are still to come. They run in reverse order of their finish in the first run, remember. But a good run, and Kay and Bob Ruff from upstate New York are among the happiest fans at this moment. A terrific run from Diane Rolf Steinrodder. Anita Vogter, third after the first run, will now take a run at Rolf Steinrodder.
And Vogter skiing out of her mind in these Olympic Games. She had no results to speak of so far this season. And no expectations. expectations for the giant slalom coming into it. She was the first one to admit that. She's the fourth-ranked Austrian in this event, and here she is, standing third. Wachter's such a wiry little skier. She flits like a bird across the course. No major mistakes up there. And Wachter skiing very aggressively down on this steep. Did you see that? Leaning in twice there, but fast. She's letting him roll, Tim.
Ahead of the leading time at the split.
Remember, she had quite a bit of time ahead of Diane Ross Steinwater on the first run. So she's got some time to play with here.
Her cumulative time on the right of the screen. To the finish line, Wachter, and into first place. Exactly the same. 2:13.71. She's tied with Ralf Steinrodder. Amazing. Well, Ralf Steinrodder seems pleased enough there. At least she's still got a share of first place. Julie Parisian, meanwhile, knocked down to third at this stage. Still two racers to come. Pernilla Wieber, who was second after the first run, will now challenge for the lead again.
And this second run, set by the Swedish coach, who undoubtedly tried to set a course that would favor Wieberg's direct style. So far, the Americans have certainly liked this course. And Wieberg, the reigning world champion in this event, only one time in the top five in giant slalom so far this year. But she seems to rise to the occasion in the big ones.
Just 21 years of age, she's had a lot of success for a young ski racer in just her third season on the World Cup circuit. That's her combined time on the right of your screen.
An incredibly aggressive skier. We'll watch her down here on this steep. She goes right at the gates. On and off her edges very quickly. Oh, and she's fast, Tim.
More than a second ahead of the co-leaders here for the combined time of the two runs.
She had such a big lead on Diane Ralf Steinrodder after the first run, but she is leaving nothing to chance on this second run.
Wieberg coming to the finish line, and she is into first place. Pernilla Wieberg standing in gold medal position, and look at that, she's blowing kisses to the crowd here, the 21-year-old from Sweden. Diane Ralf Steinrodder slips to the silver medal position along with Anita Wachter. And Ulrika Meyer is the last chance to take the gold in the giant slalom at Mirabel.
And Diane Ralf down at the bottom has got to know that regardless of what Meyer does, she is assured of a medal. She at least has the share of a bronze. But Meyer, what a story she is. Does this woman ever come on when it matters?
Meyer the leader after the first run. Super G is really her strong event, but she is such a good turner.
Well, she overturned right up there. She skied well on that first run, but it was a much more open course than this one. She's going to have to get her technical skills going in this section here.
Meyer running a little wide through that section of the gates.
Yeah, she's just, and there the time shows it, a little bit behind there, quite a bit behind. Meyer may have lost her advantage already here. She just doesn't seem to be finding the rhythm that she had on that first run. She's staying on her edges quite long. Ooh, this is not the run that she wanted.
Wieberg is the time to beat, and Meyer will not get there into fourth place. Meyer misses a medal. Wieberg is the gold medalist, and Diane Ralf Steinrodder will have a share of the silver with Anita Wachter of Austria. Congratulated by her happy American teammates, Diane Ralf Steinrodder becomes the second American alpine skier to win a silver medal, joining her teammate Hillary Lind. And her happy parents are enjoying this moment. A big day for the U.S. ski team. And for the gold medalist, Pernilla Wieberg of Sweden.